where the sheriff stands robbing like a mighty rock, and falls heir to the brave Will Scatlock.
Hey, Robin, they say you're an archer.
I have pulled a bow.
Can you split the wad?
I can try. No, Edgar, no. Your swing's too wide. You look as if you're mowing oats. Now, hold your staff at the quarter.
Black feathers.
All is well.
What did you get,
Will?
What do you got in the purse? Gold?
The outlaws are sure at Forrester making quite a name for themselves.
Oh, a king's ransom.
Must be near 100 guineas.
Hey, Jules.
What goose did you pluck today, Will?
Some kinsmen of Sir Philip's. They're on their way to the castle.
Any trouble?
No, the guards just ran like mice. Look at that.
Cheek, head, low.
We brought in some treasure.
So I see.
Aren't you too interested in gold?
Watch your head, Edgar.
The lads say it's worth 80 guineas.
That's a good many guineas. It's a fair parry.
It's a good many more than you brought in since you joined us.
Mm. Our turn's coming, isn't it, Edgar?
Thanks to you, Robin. He's a good teacher, Will.
Oh, perhaps I should take a lesson from the master.
I don't think you need any lessons in fighting, Will.
Then I can give you one.
Show him, Will. Feed him one. Yes.
You were against us, Robin Sir Philip's party, weren't you?
I said nothing.
But it was in your head.
True, I would have chosen someone else to rob.
When you need weapons and supplies, you rob. And the devil care who.
Sir Philip's a good man, and a good friend of mine.
Oh, so that's it. He's one of the gentry. He's not really one of us.
Philip treats his people well. Well, the country's full of those who don't. Why don't you rob them?
Keep your advice until you're asked, or I'll ram it down your throat.
What? Do it again, Will.
Will, you're a better man than some of your deeds. And it's true that so far I haven't earned my keep. Come on, Edgar. Let's go and try our hands at our new craft.
How about him?
He's an unpleasant-looking character.
I know him. That's Herbert of Doncaster.
Is he a friend of yours?
The devil he is. Oh, I hate moneylenders, especially that one.
Tell me the worst about him so I can commit my first robbery with an easy conscience.
Well, he comes around in winter when the people are hard put to it to find food and lends them a few shillings.
That doesn't sound so bad.
Yeah, but he collects twice as much as he lends, and those that can't pay, his friend the sheriff arrests them.
Excellent. He's our man. To your post. Ready. Are you sure? I heard stealthy footsteps in the forest. It must be the outlaws. There it is.
Probably a deer. You are a cautious fellow, no mistake. Letting an animal scare you.
I have to be cautious. I carry a full purse.
Oh. Are you a merchant?
No, I'm sort of a collection agent. Oh. As we're both going the same way, let's go together. It's safer in pairs.
Oh, as you will. Hanging fella! You nearly broke my neck! Oh!
I thought I heard them.
Oh! Your timidity is a greater menace than the outlaws! Get off me! Oh, probably a rabbit.
You can afford to be brave, since you probably carry no more than a few shillings.
Yeah.
Are you a merchant?
Well, no, not exactly. I'm a sort of a collection agent myself.
Ah, then we're colleagues. Aren't you afraid of losing your money?
Oh, no, not really. I fancy I could outwit a simple-minded outlaw.
To cover!
Yeah, hold on! Let's have no more of this hurtling into ditches.
I wish my mind was easier about my money.
Oh, put your money in your boot.
In my boot?
Yes, in your boot. And leave a few shillings in your purse for the outlaws if they should stop us.
What a splendid idea. Excuse me. My mind's at ease. But now my foot hurts.
Security must always be gained at some sacrifice.
Hand over your purse.
I'll do what he says.
Be quick about it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We'll do anything you say. Only please don't look at our boots.
Boots? Oh, boots, eh? Crafty.
Come on, hand them over.
Yes.
Acorns? You said you were a collection agent.
I am. I collect acorns.
And you. Come on. And the other one.
Look what your friend collects, Robin.
Robin? Robin? You're one of them. You're one of the outlaws. The sheriff will hang you for this.
That's right. Now run along and give my compliments to the sheriff.
But what about me boots?
Boots? Oh, yes. Very nice boots. Good.
Be the people he collected from. Do you recognize any of the names?
I don't know. Oh, I know Hawkins. He lives at Kirkbrick.
Is it far from here?
On the edge of the forest. Why?
If the moneylender collected double, then half his money belongs to the victims. We'd better make haste. This is a long list.
Trouble.
Hawkins?
Aye. Isn't that the moneylender's list?
Yes. We ran into Herbert of Doncaster on the road and arranged to do some of his business for him. In November, you borrowed 2 silver marks?
True. And I took my pig to Nottingham last week and sold it to pay the debt.
There must be some mistake.
I tell you, I paid. And there's no use trying to collect more because we haven't a farthing left.
I'm not trying to collect more. It's written here that you paid back 4 silver marks.
Aye, and we shall go hungry because of it.
I'm not surprised when you pay back double what you borrow. Give him back 2 silver marks.
Bless you, gentlemen.
I'm grateful for this friend. It can make a lot of difference.
Are you on the moneylender's list?
Yes.
What's your name?
Hugh, of the Wood. I borrowed 3 marks last winter.
What did you pay back?
6.
Give him back 3 marks.
If we should ever want to borrow money again, can we find you in Nottingham?
No. Our headquarters are in Sherwood Forest.
The men of Sherwood? I've heard about you.
You've probably heard that we're thieves and outlaws.
No. Well, I mean, one of the sheriff's men did say...
These are strange times, Hawkins. When the sheriff protects those who steal, and brands as thieves those who return the stolen goods. Now, where's Thomas Tyler?
Up over.
Come on, Edgar.
I know nothing. I just found it in my door.
Wouldn't have come from Sherwood Forest by any chance.
The outlaws? Why should they leave money?
That's what I intend to find out. I'll take this arrow to my lord, the sheriff.
Sheriff! They've robbed me!
Who robbed you?
The outlaws in the forest! And look! They took me boots!
Sit down, man. Had you collected the money?
Yes. They took £15.
If you collected £15, my share is 5. Bring it to me this afternoon.
But I told you, they robbed me.
Exactly. They robbed you, not me. I expect my share to be paid in full.
Well, you're as much to blame as I am. You're supposed to protect honest people like me from out... Lose.
Where did they find the money in your boots?
I told one of them.
You what?
Well, you don't understand. I thought he was respectable, like me. He spoke like a gentleman.
You can't tell the difference between a gentleman and a cutthroat who deserved to be robbed.
But I'll tell you, this one they call Robin would have fooled anybody, even you.
Robin? They called him Robin?
Yes.
I might have guessed it.
Howard.
Yes, sir?
You remember Robin of Locksley?
Yes, sir.
I have reason to believe that he's joined the outlaws in Sherwood Forest. And I think this arrow is his that my man brought in.
In that case, the outlaws will be even more dangerous, sir. He's a trained soldier, one of the finest archers in England.
Don't tell me what I already know. Find a way to capture him. Lay some sort of trap.
Have to be a clever one. He's nobody's fool.
We might offer some more of the same bribe. Send Herbert back again with a new pair of boots stuffed with gold.
No, not me. I don't want anything more to do with that fella. I just want me gold back.
Our gold.
You said that there were 15 guineas. Well?
That was before we gave half of them back.
Before you... What sort of outlaws are you, robbing and giving back?
To the people it belonged to, not the money lender.
Robin, this is your doing. And I give you fair warning. If you're staying with us, you'll follow our rules. We're here to stay alive. Keep out of the sheriff's reach. Not to right wrongs done by others.
If we throw in our lot with people who are wronged, we stand a better chance of staying alive and out of the sheriff's reach.
Surprise, lads. On the Watling Road, old John of Lincoln and his wagon full of wine.
How much, my guard?
Oh, just old John and his two boys. We can catch them before they get to the village, while they're still in the forest.
I wonder if it's worth it.
Why? It's worth it, all right. John of Lincoln has the best wine in Nottinghamshire.
I meant worth the risk.
Now what's sticking in your gullet? Old John's a swine and a rich one at that.
I wasn't thinking of that. Their shipment of wine just went through last week. Does it strike you as odd that another one's going through so soon?
Oh, odd or not, we're thirsty. What do you say, lads? Do we rob the wagon?
Yeah.
You can stay behind if you're afraid.
Don't miss all the fun. I'm coming along.
Tell your boys to drop their bows, John and Lincoln, or their mother will be a sorry woman tonight.
That again in the next horn you hear over Gabriel's.
Get him in here. Get
him. Whoa.
It's a trap. Take cover.
Bears from both sides.
We'll have to run for it. Scatter to the woods!
Gently with him, lads. I'll cover your retreat.
Run for it! I'm done for!
For my all, 'tis only 100 paces. Leave the rest to me.
Oh. You and Naylor take Will by the edge of the forest till you're clear of the trap. Then cut down through Badger's Hollow.
What about the sheriff's men?
You and I'll hold them off, then hide in Hawkins' hut.
How many are there?
Two, for sure. There they are.
They won't get away.
Close in!
Get your hands off me! I've done nothing! Your lordship!
Finish him off.
There, I'm no outlaw. This is my home.
He's right. He belongs to Lord Severn. I know him.
Why did you let them get into your house?
Let them? They said they'd kill me.
You're lying.
No, I'm not. I hate outlaws. I can prove it to you. You can burn me house down so long as you wipe them out.
Not a bad idea. Get a torch.
Someone will have to run in with it.
No telling how many arrows they've got left.
You. That's how you can prove your loyalty.
Don't mind burning me house down. My wife and child are in the field.
If he hesitates, run him through.
They're not coming out. They'll be roasted to death.
Roasting or hanging? What's the difference?
You were right, Robin. The wine was too costly. Too much blood in it.
What can I do for you, Will?
Take my place. You're an odd sort, Robin. But I think you're the man they'll remember.
We'll remember you.
Follow. Robin. Hood.
Should not outlive him.